Ladies and gentlemen, it is happening. Pokemon Diamond and Pearl remakes have been officially announced in the Pokemon Direct a few days ago. I know that I'm a little bit late to the party, but I wanted to kind of hop on here and discuss some thoughts about it. Of course, there was the other huge announcement of the open world Pokemon Legends game, but in today's video, we're just going to be talking about the Diamond and Pearl remakes. Now, Pokemon Diamond and Pearl are very special games to me, like I think they are to everybody else, but this was the era that introduced us to Wi-Fi battling. It was actually around the time that I started my YouTube channel. I think my first upload was in around 2008, and I kind of began getting interested in the Pokemon community on a deeper level with the introduction of Wi-Fi battling. So, Generation 4 is obviously a generation that a lot of people hold close to their hearts. I think it's one of the games that I played the most hours on. I spent the most time. It was what introduced me to all the mechanics that kind of bring you to the deeper level, which is like EV training, IV breeding, and all of that kind of stuff. So with this remake being announced, I'm extremely excited, and let's get this started off. I'm not really the person that's super hypercritical of Pokemon games especially. I'm generally just kind of go with the flow. I enjoy anything that they come out with. I wasn't the biggest fan of Sword and Shield. I think I lost a little bit of interest as time went on. I wasn't the biggest fan of kind of the art style that they decided to go with. It was still an interesting game. I still enjoy it. I still don't mind hopping on VGC and playing every once in a while. But Generation 4 is definitely different. I do think that this remake is one of the most anticipated, and they've kind of got a lot of some big shoes to fill with this. But from what we've seen so far, I've only had access to the trailer. I haven't looked at any speculation or anything like that. But I've only watched the trailer that they've given us, and I think it actually looks pretty great. I know that a lot of people obviously have issues with the kind of graphical style that they decided to go with. Obviously, the chibi Animal Crossing style character models they went with is definitely different. It's kind of grown on me a little bit. I know that a lot of people have issues with how the character models look, which is pretty important, but I think that they did relatively stay true to what those sprites kind of would look like in a more Switch-esque style. I think it's something that is definitely, it's already grown on me a little bit, having watched the trailer over a few times and seeing photos all over the place, but it's definitely something that will grow on me as time goes on, as we continue to play the game. It's not really too big of an issue to me, because I think the rest of the game honestly looks pretty great. Sinnoh, to me, is just a really cool region with a lot of different environments that will allow them to do some really interesting stuff, I think, with the graphics for this game. So one of the cooler things that I noticed from the trailer is that they're going back to the kind of top view running style, like when you're on the route, which I think is great. It stays true to the older games, and I've never really been the bigger fan in Pokemon games of kind of like the other camera views. I prefer this kind of top-down thing, so I think that's something that's going to feel really nice when thinking about these games as opposed to the originals. Another thing that I think is really interesting is they actually seem to have done a really good job in the battle environments from just the quick shots that we've seen in this gameplay footage, which obviously is not final. That's another thing to note. This gameplay footage is relatively early. This game is set to come out, at the end of this year. So they still got some time, and the game footage not being final does allow for them to go back in, adding shadows and things like that to kind of boost the graphics a little bit. So obviously this isn't final. We had an issue with that with Sword and Shield. Everybody's like, but wait, the game footage is not final. And then the textures were still, you know, pretty much the same. But I think that the battle environments in this, like when you're getting on a battle in a route, I think that's something that Pokemon has kind of lacked on in previous games. I know that it's not a huge issue for a lot of people, but I think it's just really nice to see battle environments in the place that you actually are, rather than being just placed into a random void in a gym battle and then you're just in like a green room. It feels super random and it feels lazy. But I think that from what we've seen so far, which is only some short clips, I think that, you know, the graphics so far are looking great. The Switch is going to allow for them to kind of really push this art style that they're going with. I think I prefer this type of art style over what we got with Sword and Shield. I think the only real thing that stands out to me is the character models. It's like mostly just the fact that when you're running around, you're looking super short and stubby, and then you have like the full, tall, lanky dudes when you see them in the other view, which is almost a shame, because the view of the trainers when they're standing tall, they do look great. Like, I would much prefer to have that. But as it turns out with Pokemon, you kind of you get what you get. So When it comes to just the story gameplay, I think that they're going to do a good job keeping the old charm of Sinnoh while also adding some new elements and just some new kind of twists there. There's a lot of room for them to experiment around a little bit. But I think when it really comes down to these remakes, the biggest thing for me, like I said before, I really started out in Generation 4 getting interested in Wi-Fi battling. This was the region that first introduced the Wi-Fi compatibility with the introduction of the Nintendo DS. We had the global trade. You were able to trade worldwide, and then you could connect and meet with people online and battle with them. So that really kind of, that set up competitive Pokemon for a lot of people. So for me, what they can really do to make me happy with this game is get the online right. I know that in Sword and Shield, obviously they got rid of the 60-minute battle timer and replaced it with a 20-minute battle timer, which basically renders single battles completely useless, which is obviously a huge issue. It's almost impossible to play a 6-versus-6 singles battle in the 20-minute battle timer. And I think that's kind of the main reason that I lost interest in Sword and Shield. I know that they're trying to push the motive from people to get more interested into the VGC doubles format, which I think is fine. I actually did spend some time in Sword and Shield learning VGC. It's just, it for me, it's not the same. I prefer 6-versus-6 battles. I mean, everybody has their preference, but for me, at least 6-versus-6 is something that is just nostalgic, and it's what I kind of started out battling in. So I would really like to see the 20-minute battle timer go away. If they're really going to hold true to Diamond and Pearl, they got to give us the full battle timer so that we can get some good 6-versus-6 meta back again. Something random that I was kind of thinking about, which was actually kind of cool when they introduced Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee, which actually also had the damn 20-minute battle timer, but as it was a more simplified meta, it was possible to finish more battles in the 20 minutes. But one thing I thought that was actually kind of cool that they could push and move forward with this generation is the way that you're able to find Wi-Fi battles in Let's Go and Pikachu and Eevee. I know you were able to enter like a code, and so a lot of people would do Pikachu, 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 which you were able to then find just random battles, which a lot of the people that entered that code would do just like standard OU Smogon style singles. So I think introducing kind of a method for us to find battles rather than just entering friend codes, even if the fans are able to just make it work like they did in Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee, that could be kind of cool. But I'm just really, really hoping that they stay true to Diamond and Pearl and give us back that timer, because your boy wants to get back into some singles and be able to upload some Wi-Fi battles kind of like the old days. I do really plan to kind of revive the channel and really put the effort in to get back into Pokemon Wi-Fi battling with this generation, because that was where it all started out. They've already introduced a lot of mechanics that make it a lot easier to get into competitive battling, with all of the mechanics that now make it much easier for items, setting up IVs, EV training is extremely easy. So making that as easy for people to get into, I think, has been a good turn that Pokemon, they've taken a good direction with that lately. But with this, I would really like to see singles be revived. Obviously, this whole side of it is mostly just me. I know that a lot of people aren't really interested in the online aspect of the Pokemon games, but I do hope it's something that they kind of realize. A lot of the hardcore fans do want to see the online metagames of Pokemon, you know, thrive. And I think that with the introduction of this, they can definitely make that happen if they decide to. Please, please, Game Freak, help us out. On a whole other side of it, another thing that I forgot to mention, one other thing that I do really love about Sinnoh is kind of the legendaries and the lore behind them. I think that Sinnoh has some really interesting legendaries, and I'm really excited to see kind of what they do for the treatment of these. I mean, they could bring back a lot of cool things. They could do some Arceus stuff with the Azure Flute, which I think could be awesome. Unfortunately, I don't believe we're going to get the Distortion World, which would look sick, but with all the legendaries, Palkia, Dialga, freaking Arceus, they have some really cool stuff to run with, and I think that with the graphics that we know is possible on the Switch, Pokemon should be able to allocate the funds to give us some really cool interactions with the legendaries in this game, which is definitely something I'm looking forward to, because Again, those were the legendaries that I spent a lot of time as a young lad messing around with in the OG games. But I think that all of the Pokemon in Sinnoh in general are beautiful. This is going to be a great way to introduce newer fans to the Sinnoh region. A lot of people weren't around playing Pokemon when these original games came out. So I think that they have the ability to really give a lasting impression on newer Pokemon fans and kind of get the Sinnoh region the love that it deserves, because I know I really enjoyed it when I was first getting into Pokemon, and I think a lot of people should be able to feel the same way. So yeah, guys, that is kind of my current thoughts on the whole situation regarding the Diamond and Pearl remakes. I am extremely excited for this, as I think a lot of people are. Let me know in the comment section what you're most excited for with these remakes, or if there's anything that you're upset about or anything you really enjoyed. Just let me know in the comments. Thanks, guys.